female performers in professional wrestling are treated in the same fashion that child actors have been in recent years. Women in professional wrestling have been the hottest and most provocative television stars of the late 1990s. But what goes on behind the closed locker room door? What truly happens behind the curtain of professional wrestling? Tonight, we expose the truth in a story no other network would dare allow to be broadcast. We rip the lid off of our own industry. The performer formerly known as Sonny, Tammy Lynn Sitch, blows the lid off of professional wrestling tonight, exclusively on TNN.
No doubt will be talked about for years to come in the entertainment industry. We will have a very candid conversation with Tammy Lynn Sitch, formerly Sonny, in the World Wrestling Federation. Tammy will speak out, I guess what we can call an expose, about the enormous pressures and the stress and the sometimes absurd working conditions of women in the professional wrestling industry. This is going to upset a lot of people in the wrestling business and perhaps shock a lot of people in the entertainment industry. And all that is coming up tonight, a historic edition of ECW on TNN.
Wrist can, you know what? Cover! That Landstorm beat! She broke up the three count! Candido can't believe it! Behind you, dear. Behind you! Tammy Lynn Sitch had seen it all! Haymaker Bill! Cat fight! Cat fight! ECW!
In 1994, legendary professional wrestling manager Jim Cornette introduced the world to Tammy Lynn Sitch in the now defunct Smoky Mountain Wrestling promotion in Knoxville, Tennessee.
We felt like we were really cool. We felt on top of the world at that moment.
The very next year, Tammy received her big break. She was summoned to the World Wrestling Federation, where she adopted the persona of Sonny and was overwhelmed by the bizarre world of fame and adulation.
There's a site on the internet, Tammy's Feet. It's all pictures of, like, where you can see my bare feet, dedicated to my feet and my toes.
So what do you think? Is this worth an internet site?
Trust me, there are better parts of me to look at. Although, I do like my feet pretty much.
But for Tammy, the price of fame was way too high, because the pressure of being wrestling's hottest sex symbol was too much for her to handle.
Well, there are many different reactions in my life to the pressure that was put on me. I would have to say prescription drug abuse. And most problems would be a muscle relaxer named Soma. I would say it's pretty widespread amongst a lot of athletes in the business. I really do, because there are sometimes you can go into anybody's locker room and people are could be there passing them out if you want them.
How dangerous is Soma?
Very. Good friend of ours died from mixing that with alcohol.
Tell me about it.
Well, his name is Luis Piccoli, and he had a fun night out in LA one night with friends, drinking and taking his pill. Went back to his house, fell asleep, never woke up. Well, he did wake up once. It was 6 o'clock in the morning, turned off his answering machine, and then he choked it to death because he couldn't get up out of bed. Because if you take enough of those things, you can be pretty much almost just like paralyzed. And that was pretty rough. And then we lost him.
How's this for a thrill? The Friday Night Thrill Zone continues as Tammy Lynn Stitch bears all.
I was considered old by any, you know, 1997, and I was only 24 years old. And I was called the click chick because they were friendly to me. I was friendly to them. I would make their, like, hotel reservations. But I prefer to be pushed on my own talent instead of who I am friends with, who I am dating, who I am sleeping with, who I eat dinner with. I would prefer to be myself and be pushed as what I do and how I can do it. When I first left the World Wrestling Federation, it was like a weight was lifted off my shoulders. I could relax, I could have a home, I could, you know, do everything I want to do, but I didn't see myself taking advantage of that yet. I saw myself just digging a hole deeper for myself. I took too much advantage of being able to sit home and not do anything, and, you know, I felt too relaxed in my environment. Too relaxed to the point where I finally did take my first drink. My first drink was at home when there were no more pills to make you go to sleep. There have been times when my dad died, I wanted to go with him. When my niece died, I wanted to be there with her too. Stacy, she died when she was 16. I was in the hospital and she was on life support. And I was holding her hand and she died. And she went cold in my hands. I didn't want to let her go. I couldn't let her go. And there were some nights that I was hoping I wouldn't wake up next morning.
Tell me about it. Describe that feeling.
The worst feeling in the world. Worst feeling in the world. To know that you don't care if you wake up in the next morning or not.
Come on.
You can talk about your Sables. You can talk about your Debras. You've got your Nitro Girls. You've got your Dawn Maries. But I'm gonna set the standard by which every girl in this business is judged. Again. Because girls, I'm alive. And I'm back.
Revert back to your old habits and take a power.